Hello, ladies. God bless you guys. How are you guys on this precious day? It's Janice Batista. You already know. I am so excited about this video because I'm gonna title it New Year, New Me. Now, I know I was thinking about, like, should I really do this? Because, you know, that line is kind of cheesy. You know what I'm saying? But, okay, there's something that I want to, I feel like the Lord is speaking to me this morning. He's definitely pouring something into my spirit about New Year, New Me. And I know that a lot of you guys this year have been going through a lot of stress. You guys have been going through a lot of drama, especially relationship drama. I know that you've been having to deal with a lot on your plate, and I know that this hasn't been an easy year for you. But I know people get tired of hearing that new year, new me. And one of the things that the Lord was really ministering into my heart this morning is that there's nothing wrong with being a new you. Because every year, God gives us another opportunity to learn and grow from our mistakes. Now, a lot of people, when they say, oh, I'm so sick and tired of hearing that new me, new year, why are they sick and tired of that? They're sick and tired of that because they keep seeing people bringing the old junk from last year into the new year, and they're like, man, you're not trying to change. You're bringing that old junk from last year into new year. And one of the things that I wanted to speak to you about today is not bringing in the old junk. And I actually put a little quote on my Facebook today, and it was really ministering to my heart, and I really pray that it ministers to your heart as well. It says, the new year stands before us, okay, like a chapter in a book waiting to be written. We can help write the story by setting goals, okay? And then I put new year, new me. Now, we have to be open with grabbing the pen. Like, I got a whole bunch of pretty little pens here. Let me grab a little hot pink one because I'm like very girly. Okay, so there's nothing wrong with setting goals. So, like, let's say if one of your goals is to, you know what, I actually want to own my own house. You write your mistakes down. Write everything that you've been doing this past year that wasn't allowing you to actually save the money to get a home, okay? And if it's you don't have any extra money for this new year, write it down. Say, you know what, this new year I want to buy a house, so I'm gonna get a second job, and everything that I earn from that job is going to be towards my down payment to the house. I'm just using that as a little example. Whether you want a new car, whether you're looking for a relationship, whether you're looking to take your relationship to the next level, you know, maybe you've been dating your partner for a certain amount of time and you're ready. Like, maybe you're just so tired of the drama in your relationship that you're ready to just give up and give in and take your relationship to the next level. You know, whatever it is that you want to do, I'm here to tell you that you can do it. Don't ever let anybody tell you that you cannot do anything. That's one of the things that's in my vocabulary. I never like to say I can't. If there's something that I can't do, believe me, I will fail at it 100 times before I get it right. But one thing about me, for those of you that know me, know that I will not quit. Once I have my eyes on something, I try to go after it. I don't like to quit. I don't like to give up. Why am I like that? I'm like that because at one point in my life, I remember years back, okay, I remember all my failures. I remember all the mistakes that I've made. And I remember, that's why when I say, we're going into a new year. That's why when I say new year, new me, it's okay to say new year, new me, because it's nothing wrong with you wanting to change. There's nothing wrong. You know, a lot of people, they like to put people in a box, and they think that if you're the type of person that let's say you a thief or a liar, whatever your problem may be, a lot of people, once they see you as a certain type of person, they like to label you as that, and they think that people can't change. And I'm a firm believer that people can change. People, I believe in second chances. I believe that God, you know, gives us always a new day and a new opportunity to grow from our mistakes, to learn from all the errors, to learn from all the storms that we're facing. And one of the words that I wanted to share with you guys today is in 2 Thessalonians, and it says, may the Lord bring you into a deeper understanding of the love of God and of the patience that comes from Christ, okay? There is such a deep understanding and a deep knowledge and knowing who God is. But sometimes we go through financial crisis, we go through relationship problems, marriage problems, we go through family problems, and all of these things have to do with the love of Christ. The love of Christ is not just all love. The love of Christ, when you know, you have to be enduring, you have to be long suffering. That's why the word of God says that he that endureth unto the end, okay, he's the one that's gonna be saved. He's the one that's gonna win the crown. This is in life where everything that we're doing is a race. You're going to work every day because you have goals, you gotta pay the bills, you got things that you gotta put on the table. You have, you know, there's probably mouths you got to feed, you gotta buy clothes for your children, you gotta buy things that, you know, your household necessities, you gotta buy your clothes, you know, get your hair done, whatever it is that you got on your monthly budget, you got goals, you got moves that you're trying to do, and sometimes those things don't always go as planned. And I know that throughout this year, you may have had a lot of bumps in the road. And that's the beautiful thing about God. God allows those bumps in the road so that next year, when you go into that new you, you're able to see the bumps. And before you actually, you know, you ever, I don't know about you guys, but I don't know if you guys have a truck or know what I'm talking about. I have a Ford Expedition. So it's a big truck. So when I'm driving and there's like a speed bump and I don't see it, man, that thing, when I hit a speed bump and I didn't see it and I didn't slow down, that whole truck, man, goes up like that, boom, down, and I feel like my neck almost got a whiplash. But that's the beautiful thing about God. When you see a bump, when you see the mistakes that you made in 2017, God allows those things to happen so that you can process everything that happened, so that you can learn from it and grow from it and take notes. And then when you see those bumps coming in on 2018, you say, and you know, you tell the enemy, I'm not gonna go down that road because I already know there's bumps in the road. You know, that's why the Bible talks about the straight and narrow road. A lot of people, they like to, you know, walk through the matter of fact, let me find that verse real quick. Hold on. Straight and narrow road. Hold on, narrow Bible verse, because I want to give y'all the word, and I want you guys to write it down, okay? This one is Matthew 7:14, okay? It says, but small is the gate and narrow is the road that leads to life, and only few find it. You see, very few people find the narrow road. A lot of people, they want to go through the easy, they like to take the easy way out. They don't like to go through the suffering. They don't like to go through the trouble. And that's the, when you say to yourself, you know what, I don't want to go through the struggle, I don't want to go through the process, what you're doing is saying to God, you know what, God, I don't want your wisdom. I don't want to cry. I don't want to suffer. But guess what? All of that is part of the process. And when I sit here and tell you, and I always tell you guys this because I'm always transparent. I'm very thankful. I'm always thankful for the people that betray me, the people that give me their butt to kiss. Like I always tell y'all, the people that have walked out on me, I am so thankful, because it's in those places that I've learned to grow in a deeper relationship with God. Sometimes you can sit there and say to yourself, you know what, I got a good relationship with God. But until you deal with the people walking out on you, until you deal with situations where you're face to face alone with God, and you see that everybody walked out on you, there's nothing but trust in God. And that's what I'm telling you, like, even having the church, for going into our fifth year, even when people have walked out on us in the church, it's things that we've endured, it's things that we've been through. And God, even in this new year, you think that God is not gonna see, okay, this is Johnny and this is Janice and this is everything that they put before you? You know, the angels, they're consistently telling God things that we're doing. God is consistently watching. God is like, you know what, these are the things, God, that they have placed before you for 2017. God, these are their plans, this is the vision for 2018. And God sends his angels to deposit vision, to deposit goals into our lives, into our heart. And you know, I don't know exactly what it is that, you know, your mission and your calling may be in life. You know, maybe God is going to use you to work, like I said before, in the children's ministry, worship ministry. Maybe he wants you to deal with, open up a homeless ministry and minister to people in the street. You know, I don't know what God is calling you to, but whatever it is that he's calling you to do, know that you're going to be able to do it. You're going to be able to move forward because God has he called you. He says, I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. I knew you. I called you. I appointed you to be a prophet. And you know, you just got to stay strong and definitely stick to your goals, write them down and stick to them, and don't be afraid about removing the naysayers. Don't be afraid about removing the negativity out of your life, because sometimes to continue growing, we have to remove the old leaven. We have to remove the, you know, the things that don't make us unequally yoked. You know, we have to remove the things that don't align us with the presence of God, the things that don't align us to spiritually grow. I know me, throughout each year since the day I became a Christian until today, you know, there's been so many things that I've learned year after year. Like, when I sit here and think, like, you know what, God, all the things that you taught me, like, I was looking at all the pictures with my sister, you know, on how our lives have changed drastically, how we've grown up, how we've matured so much. And honestly, it's like, you just gotta enjoy the process. Enjoy the process of going into that new you. Enjoy the process. I always tell the ladies, there's nothing like taking a bath and putting some perfume and lotion and just doing your hair and putting on some pretty clothes. There's nothing like that feeling, because it's you got to take care of yourself. God calls us to take care of ourselves, to embrace ourselves, and you got to embrace yourself even in those moments. Like right now, you guys see me with my hair all pretty and stuff like that and my pretty shirt, and you know, but there are times when I didn't feel this pretty. There are times where I'm not feeling pretty, and I've had to learn to, you know, through the mistakes. I've had to learn through the betrayal. I had to learn through the different processes that I've had to endure in my life. I had to look at those moments and be like, oh man, am I gonna let this process eat me alive, or am I gonna, you know, go into it? Like I said in 2 Thessalonians, may the Lord bring you into a deeper understanding of the love of God. I had to sit there and say, God, do I want to go into this deeper understanding with you? And when I sit there and I really made up my mind, and I was like, you know what? I do. I do, God. I'm not going to give up on you. I'm not going to, you know, give up on you because things didn't look right, or things didn't pan out right. You know, I'm going to definitely, you know, give you my all. And then that's when I learned. It says when you go even deeper into a deeper understanding of the love of God and of the patience that comes from Christ, we are all sinners. We fall short from the glory of God. Anybody that says that they don't is a liar. A lot of people, they'll like to point the finger and be like, oh, you the problem. You the sinner. You. But what does the word say? We all fall short of the glory of God. That's why sometimes when you see me and I don't hang out with certain people, it's because I don't like people that think that their stuff don't stink. I can't stand being around people that think that they're so pretty and perfect and that they're so flawless. We all make mistakes, and the people that I love and the people that I respect are people that know, you know, they in a hole. People that know that they not perfect. People that know that they made mistakes, but they could come together. When you come together and you talk about your mistakes, when you come together and you talk about your flaws, and you do it like an adult, you're able to progress. And in this new year, you know, maybe you've had family issues, maybe you had family problems. You know what? There is nothing impossible for the Lord. You just have to be willing to place everything before his feet and say, God, these are my problems. These are the things that have afflicted me in 2017. God, this is all the people that betrayed me this year. God, these are all the people that stabbed me in the back. God, these are all the people that walked out on me. God, these are all my dreams that I tried to accomplish, God, but I tried to accomplish them without you. All he's waiting is for you to just pour your heart out unto him and just let him know. Just speak to him from the most intimate space in your heart and just worship him and say, God, you know what? People walked out on me, but you know what? This year, God, I'm still going to worship you. God, I'm still going to lift my hands, God, because I know that you are good. I know that you are worthy, and you are worthy to be praised. And just continue and declare over your life. Declare. The words have power. Okay, declare and say, God, you know what? This year, our finances wasn't good, but God, I declare that our finances are gonna be good this year. God, I cover my finances with the blood of Jesus. I cover my finances. I cover my home. Father God, maybe your home was struck with sickness. Cover your home. Declare and decree over your home and say, God, this year, I cancel every sickness that wants to creep up into my home. Father God, and I bind it in the name of Jesus. I cancel it out and I rebuke every demonic force that tries to raise up against my children, against my marriage. Like, you gotta be that prayer warrior this year. If there's something that you wanna inspire to be this year, inspire to be a prayer warrior. War for the things that belong to you. Because right now is like, you know, there's a thing that says new levels bring new devils. There are so many new things that are gonna be happening in this year. There's so many new devils that are already lining up for you for January. They're lining up for you for February to destroy your purpose. They're lining up for March. They're lining up. All right, this is, they're already planning. They already got a game plan set. Like, all right, this is what we're gonna do in January, how we're gonna destroy her. And if that doesn't work, we're gonna go try to destroy her in February like this. Because there are people, there are demonic forces and rulers in high places that their job 24/7 is to destroy you, is to stop you from getting to know the love of God, is to stop you from going to church, is to stop you from growing. And it's one thing to always say, oh, you know what, God, this year I promise I'm gonna get closer to you. No, write it down. Say, you know what, I want to get close to God. So what do I gotta do to get close to God? I gotta get connected. I gotta get plugged in. So how am I gonna plug myself in with some Christian believers? How am I gonna, which church am I gonna attend? How am I gonna plug myself into the house of God? How am I gonna get spiritually and nourishly fed, so, you know, so that my spirit can grow, so that my soul can be fed? You know, those are things. And how can I do that? You know what? I got to find a church. So what that means, you got to write it down. Say, you know what? I'm going to visit 5 churches and I'm going to have to pick one of them out of those 5 churches. Maybe one may not have all the worship team together. Maybe one, the word may not be all that and the worship team is put together. Like, you got to pick and choose what's important to you. Maybe one, the church may not be big, but the pastors are full of the love of Christ. You know, maybe, you know, the other church is big, but everybody's arrogant. I don't know what you're looking for. I don't know what it is that you need to grow. But what I'm saying is that whatever it is that you need to grow, write it down and execute that thing. Because God's plan and God's vision for your life has to do with all your trials, has to do with all your turmoils. And he's gonna judge you on everything that you did, whether it was good or whether it was bad, on everything you said, on everything you acted on. God is gonna judge you on each and every one of those things. So make sure that as you're entering into this new year, make sure that you prepare yourself for the battlefield. Make sure that you prepare yourself to understand what spiritual warfare is. Make sure you prepare yourself. Don't wait till the sickness knocks on your door. Don't wait for the tragedy to knock on your door. Don't wait for the destruction of your finances to knock on your door. Don't wait for the fall of your Christian faith to knock on the door. Stop everything in their tracks now and declare now. Say, God, you know what? This year, no matter what comes, Father God, I'm going to embrace it and I'm going to grow and I'm going to come back stronger than ever. They always say the comeback is better than the setback. Amen. So, you know, I just pray that this word was a blessing to your life, and don't let nothing hinder you. Don't let nothing stop you, and understand the love of God. Understand that the patience of God comes through Christ. Anything that you face in your life, you need Christ. Christ has to be the foundation to everything, because the word of God teaches us that, you know, the house that was able to withstand the storm was the house that was founded on the rock. So make sure that for 2018, when you declaring that new me, you know, new mindset, new attitude, make sure that you embrace it. Embrace that new you. Embrace it. And I, one of the things that I told my sister when I was talking to her, I said, you know, the beautiful thing about a lion, like a lion, and you know, is one of my favorite animals, and I love the lions, I love the tigers, but you know what makes them beautiful is their scars. They're not ashamed of their scars. And if you ever look at ask a lot of people, like, yo, what's the cutest, you know, animal you ever seen? A lot of people will, you know, say maybe a tiger, a lion, something like that, like wild animal. You know, they're cuter than the bears. They're cuter than all the wolves. They're cuter than a lot of things. Why? Because their scars, they show their strength. When you see a lion, like you see the Lion of Judah, like when you see a lion, it shows their strength. It shows their courage. And, you know, that's, you know, all the bumps you've had to endure, all the people that you walked out on, your failed relationships, all of that has to do with the plan and the purpose of God. So, you know, just embrace who you are. Embrace who you are. And I'm telling you, even if in this year there were many people that didn't embrace who you are, maybe there were many people that, you know, just didn't get you, pray to God. And I'm declaring over you that in this year, you're going to have people that do get you. You're going to have people that do understand you. You're going to have people this year that are going to help you and take you to that next level, because this year is a year of victory. I declare it over your life. I declare it over my life, over our ministry. And there is nothing, the plans of the enemy against his children this year will not prosper. Amen. The storms could come, but guess what? If our house is founded on the rock, who's gonna be able to withstand the house founded on the rock? Amen. So I love you guys, and I hope that you guys enjoy. And like I said, I'm sorry I couldn't be able to do all the videos lately. You guys know that I had flooding happen in my house, from the upstairs bathroom downstairs, and today finally the people came out to look at all the damages and stuff like that. So, you know, we've been kind of really busy, you know, putting things together in the house and just trying to repair all the damages. But, you know, God is good. He's providing, he's opening doors, he's doing so many amazing things, and for that I thank him, and for that I give him glory, because he is good, and he is good all the time. Okay guys, so I love you guys, and I'll catch you guys next year.